It's Sean Lam here for Streaming Media Producer. I'm here with Jeremy from Atomos, and we're looking at the Samurai Blade. This is an update on the original Samurai. What have you done?
Okay, so we got some feedback. The customers were quite happy with the operating system, but they weren't happy with the small BNCs.
Yeah.
And we gave them the cable, so they were kind of happy in the end, but we've decided to put some big
full-size ones
on.
Yeah, which, those little pigtail ones.
Which we didn't think
ones,
we could fit, actually, but we managed to do it.
Okay.
We had to have some custom ones made, but that's all good now. And the biggest thing is that we've updated the screen. So this is a 1280 by 720 5-inch screen.
Okay.
You can see it's a full 16:9 perfect aspect ratio. We worked with a panel partner to customize this panel. You get 48 hertz, 50 hertz, 60 hertz operations. Whatever the video format is, it changes to that frequency so that you see actually the perfect video.
Yeah.
Simply color spec, we can adjust gamma and contrast brightness. Like, we've got full range of control over that. So it's really an awesome IPS panel. We call it the Super Atom IPS panel.
Okay.
So we say super sharp, super bright, and super blacks. Yeah, all the way down to the last atom.
And so this one here is an IPS, the previous was probably a TN?
It was an LCD.
An LCD,
yeah.
Okay.
Or TFT.
TFT,
yeah,
okay.
There was a change from TFT to LCD, and it's right in the in between those two. So
it's definitely a lot nicer screen
on here.
Yeah,
got viewing angle, is as you can see there.
Yeah.
You've got pretty much 180 degree viewing angle. And we've also made a hood for it. Which was something that we did miss on the, and people had to buy hood man things and different things. So we've made one that's a little bit sturdier and a little bit cleverer.
All right, so you still support the same ProRes, the HQ, the LT?
Correct. The whole operating system from AtomOS 4 is ingested into this. But probably the main big feature is that we have now added waveform monitoring.
Okay.
And what that gives you, like, Tektronix level accuracy on RGB, Luma Parade, vectorscope, and that's just a button here to just bring up the waveform.
Okay.
So that now completes the monitoring tools, so that we can now, with a kick-ass screen at 325 DPI, you can seriously focus off this.
Yeah.
With the monitoring tools, we've updated also our filters for focus peaking. And we only went in the horizontal direction originally. Now we go in both directions, which smooths out the edges and gives you a lot more detail in the... The old focus peaking worked really well, especially for cameras that didn't have it. But I wanted to improve it, so our engineers worked hard to get that done.
All right, so a better monitor now.
Better monitor, waveform functions.
What about recording in terms of, like, log capabilities?
Yeah, so we can take the S-log or C-log from the Sony cameras, and that's then recorded. It's not a separate file, but it's recorded inside the video stream.
Okay.
And then when you come back into, like, a final cut, etc., then that's what you're viewing, is the S-log. And then you can get in and adjust gammas and different things inside the editing package.
So one of the most important things, I think, when you have an external recorder is powering. So the original model had battery power, and you also have the ability to AC power this, right?
Correct, and we now include that in the box.
Okay.
So we used to include two batteries and a charger. That was more because we saw it being a portable device sitting out on cameras all the time. But we did get a lot of requests, I need an AC adapter. So we were asking people to buy the Sony one that's clicked on there. That wasn't a great solution because it was kind of separate to a purchase from Atomos. So we now include the AC power adapter in the box.
And then when it's AC powered and it has a battery on one side,
yep.
and let's say we lose power in the AC, what happens?
Flicks straight across.
Excellent.
Yeah, seamlessly. I think it's like a couple of milliseconds and it's up and running. The operating system continues to function completely.
So we don't lose power on the record?
Never.
What happens if we do lose power on the record?
Okay, so or you pull the disc out, same scenario.
That's right.
So all that happens there is that you don't close the file properly because you've lost power and the operating system can't close the file. So when you power it back up or put the disc back in, then we see that it's a broken file. We reconstruct the headers, because the frames are still there on the disc, they just haven't been pointed to correctly.
That's right.
So we then reconstruct the headers, and it comes up with, we've seen a broken video file, would you like to recover it? And you can do it now, or if you're in the middle of a shoot, then you can do it later.
Yes, that's excellent, because I know I was on a shoot previous,
yes.
and we were using a Key Pro, and we had a Samurai and we lost power.
Yes.
And there was no battery backup in either of the two.
Yes.
And we powered them both back up, and this was the one we were able to actually recover from, or at least the Samurai, not the Blade version of it.
Yes.
Whereas the Key Pro, we were told we had to send that away to an independent third-party company,
to get
$400.
And we used to have the same issue, but then we built it into the operating system because we saw it as a really, safety is probably everything for, you know, video shooting.
That's right.
That's why we have locking mechanisms, as you know, for the hard disk. We have locks on the batteries.
Yeah.
That's a peace of mind, as well as a very important function. And file recovery is extremely important. If you've been shooting for an hour, and suddenly something happens, you definitely don't want to not be able to recover your
never
files.
Never want to lose your file, so. No. Excellent. Price and availability, Jeremy?
Okay, $12,95, and it will be available end of May, beginning of June. We're hoping to get it out by the end of May. It could slip to the first week of June, but we are exactly on target for, we have a different manufacturing process now. Now that our volume's gone up, we've had to go to a bigger manufacturer. And what that allows us, well, it causes us to have to plan more.
Yes.
And so this has been in the works for 3 months, and that date cannot be changed. So middle of May, we start that production.
Yes.
And then obviously it's finished that in about a week, do QA testing on it, ship it out.
Okay. What about Samurai owners? Are they still gonna be supported?
Of course they're gonna be supported. We're not getting rid of the original Samurai because we see that as a real workhorse SDI product. We've sold a lot of units for specific purposes like recording switcher feeds, of course on top of cameras, like the camera you're using here, the FS700 has had a lot of Samurai users.
Yeah.
You can take the slow motion in 25p or 30p. So we're not letting them fall by the wayside and have to, in fact, we will continue to update the operating system with audio level meters, things like this that customers are asking for. So they're all in the pipe. And as you know, we do updates very often.
Yes.
And improve functionality. Samurai goes to $995. So it's $300 cheaper.
Okay.
It's dropped $600.
Yes.
And obviously with the Blade coming out. And the reason for the price drop is that our volume's gone up enough that our buying power has increased, mm-hmm. and we can pass that on to the customer, okay. which is what we always want to do.
Exactly. So now you mentioned audio.
Meters, yep.
Yes, that was one of my big feedbacks was
yes.
that I was always challenged having the small ones, and so now
they were never supposed to remain that size.
Okay.
But then we had other features we wanted to put in, and as you know, like life, you get busy on other things. But once Blade is out and Atom OS 5 is finished, which will be when Blade is shipped,
okay.
then we want to clean up a few of the extra features. And give them back into, and some of the features in Blade will go into Atom OS 4. Waveform won't. We just don't have enough grunt inside. But we might do some user interface adjustments. They'll get the audio level meters. They'll probably get the improved peaking that we've put into the Blade. So Atom OS 4 will continue to develop. And really, it's only because we can't push that hardware anymore. Things move on and we get more. More grunt for a similar cost.
All right, well, thank you very much, Jeremy. This has been a look at the Samurai Blade and the updates to the Atom OS. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I really just wanted to highlight the 5D Mark III with clean, uncompressed out straight to a Ninja 2. And one of the big announcements we have at the show is Ninja 2 has been reduced in price by $300 down to $695. So it's becoming much more affordable for all customers out there. And as you can see here, I have a clean uncompressed out coming from the 5D Mark III. Now that's a beautiful image from their great sensor. There's a lot of people love this camera, and Canon has really come to the fore. We worked very closely with them on development of the start-stop and start-stop trigger from the camera to our recorder and timecode. So that was really a nice experience working with the Canon development team. They asked us how we would like it implemented, and here's how it works. So I've got my time code coming in here from the camera, and if I hit start, now I'm recording. So you can see the red bars here, and you can see the red dot down here. Now I'm recording 1080p 24 on both. So this is an MPEG recording, and this is a ProRes recording up here. So that's what customers have been wanting, that's what they've been asking for. We sync them up with time code and exactly the same start-stop point. So we think that's probably one of the best solutions on the market for the DSLR ranges. There's also the D800 and Nikon are coming very strong with $400 versions of the 3200, 5200, 7100. These are $400, $800, $1,000 cameras that all have clean uncompressed out to us. So they're really going hard for that lower end market. Sony have their Alpha 99, which is an amazing camera. You can see they put a lot of their video knowledge in there. I see this FS700, that's the same group making that camera. So I see this marketplace as the future of affordable, high quality, independent productions. And go and check it out, 695. Pretty much every reseller around the country has these in stock. And you can go and see. Canon are releasing this firmware. They have indicated, not confirmed, but that it's gonna be in April. And we expect that to be at the end of this month. But you can see, this is working. We haven't had any problems with it. We've been testing it for about a month now. So we expect this to be the final release version.
Thank you. Excellent.
No problem.